If you already have a website, then adding a blog is as easy as adding a page or a section to your existing site, so you don't have to choose which blog builder to use.
But if you're just starting out, you may be considering WordPress versus a website builder. I'm Darlene, this is Emily, and we're going to share a little bit about each option so you can determine which is the right choice for you and your blog.
The first thing you should consider are your technical skills. A website builder provides a quick drag and drop interface that makes creating and designing a blog a breeze.
It helps you design your site from the beginning by providing a variety of themes and allowing you to customize colors and fonts. As you make selections, you can see the changes happening on the screen, which is a nice touch.
Another benefit of using a website builder is the added built-in functionality that will help you grow your blog. Things like an SEO wizard or ways to connect your website to social media and email marketing tools, just to name a few.
WordPress can do a lot of those same things, but it does take a little more technical knowledge. When you choose WordPress, there's an installation wizard that helps you start building the site. And once you're done with the wizard, you'll still need to install themes and plugins to get the look and feel that you want.
Installing a theme sets the tone for your site, and plugins extend the functionality. Since WordPress is an open source platform, there are millions of people adding new plugins you can use to enhance features on your site.
You can add plugins for security, SEO, email marketing, and more. There's a saying, if you want to add something to your site, there's probably a plugin for it.
In WordPress, you won't see changes happening on the screen as you make them like you do in a website builder. And using the plugins or getting the site to have the exact look and feel that you want may have a slight learning curve.
Since WordPress is an open source platform, you can often find help and videos on the internet and learn how to do things that way. But if you're a first-time user and you don't have the time to learn how to use WordPress, then a website builder may be a better option.
Which brings us to the next thing you should consider, time. How much time do you have to maintain your site?
With a website builder, you're going to want to provide new content, and in your case, a new blog post on the regular. But you don't have to worry about keeping your site updated with the current plugins and themes, because that's all maintained by us.
WordPress requires a little more maintenance. You're responsible for keeping plugins and themes updated.
Since WordPress is an open source platform, plugin and theme creators will update the code as needed to keep hackers out. You'll see when updates are needed on your admin dashboard, and it's your responsibility to make sure you check and install them.
Both website builders and WordPress are great tools for getting your blog up and running. So take some of the items we've discussed into consideration and choose the one that'll work best for you. I'm Emily, this is Darlene, and we look forward to seeing your blog online.